This video is in response to CGP Grey concluding that humans will become obsolete in the future, just as horses became obsolete in the past once their horsepower was no longer needed. Curiously enough, although horse numbers in the USA have dropped from 20 million to 5 million once mechanized machine muscles started making money in recent times, there has been a steady growth of horse population to 7 million and rising due to something economists call marginal utility. This simply means that people still value horses for other, less economically justifiable reasons, such as entertainment or a very expensive form of pet keeping. Luckily for horses, mechanization allowed the population of humans to flourish, and more importantly, those humans became wealthier as well. With all that newly created wealth sloshing about, it was suddenly far less expensive to keep horses around. And this all brings us to humans and our predicament in some future AI-populated world. In all likelihood, most AI entities would not care much for humans at all, just as most humans don't think much about horses on a daily basis. On the other hand, the growth of a super-intelligent AI civilization would likely be even faster than our own, and all that it would take is a marginal interest on behalf of a minority of the entire AI civilization to keep all of humanity alive with pocket change. Not only that, but the most likely path for human civilization to spread throughout the cosmos is on the back of AI-designed, built, and operated ships. This may sound silly at first, but many species on this Earth have found new lands of opportunity as passengers of human sail ships of yore. Does this all just mean that you will become a pampered pet with a basic income? Well, highly unlikely. As our own flesh and blood rulers discovered long ago, keeping humans occupied with a job, really any kind of a job, even an economically unjustifiable job, is far less likely to lead to undesirable human behavior. So rejoice one and rejoice all. We will all likely end up as employees on jobs that serve no real purpose but to amuse machines with a level of skill and talent that we can perform on a given task. Much like horses that run in a circle or have to amuse rich dentists' daughters with rides around the shire, from the human perspective, the tasks may seem actually exceptionally meaningful and often record-breaking, at least for the humankind. And even today's humans can make an exceptionally good living if they too can run in a circle, well, during the Olympics. The best part is the compensation package, which is likely to surpass anything that practically any human alive can get today. Youthful and exceptionally well-toned and attractive body with a sharp wit and positive personality to match, both genetically and medically guaranteed, and that's just for the starters. Now, this all may seem too rosy, and it's natural to wonder if there would be some kind of vile outcome with morbidly minded AI torturing humans in experiments, but the answer to that question is very likely not. There are humans that do not like horses at all, and may even want to torture them, but it is unlikely that they will spend the money on a horse farm. Well, even people that keep ants have codes of conduct regarding the avoidance of unnecessary harm to their ant colonies. If you come across a community of ant keepers, it would not be advisable to introduce oneself by disclosing all of the fantastic ways that ant colonies can be made to suffer. We would be kept as an artifact of the past in the history of the future that is to be written by super-intelligent AI space colonizing civilization. But that's not such a bad deal. And actually, it may already have happened.